mandatory injunction on Kwabena Kwabena's live concerts slated for tonight. The judge described the application as deliberate and in bad faith.
The injunction was being sought by ABBA Investments, an events organizing firm, which worked with the musician to stage the F14 concert on two previous occasions. ABBA Investments accused the highlife artist and his team of submitting a similar proposal as theirs to the title sponsor and using images from previous F14 concerts to promote their show, thereby confusing the general public into thinking the two shows were the same. As part of the application for the injunction, counsel for the plaintiff, Joseph Bernard Ashale, argued, should the love concerts be allowed to take place, the F14 brand would suffer irreparable damage and ABBA Investment would be robbed of what he termed the glory it had built in the last 4 years. The counsel for the respondents, KBKB Music Limited and Kwabena Kwabena, Kwame Okufu, however, maintained the issue of unlawful usage of the plaintiff's images and concept in the proposal could not hold, as Kwabena Kwabena did not assign his image rights to the plaintiff or a law that trademarks concept. He accused the plaintiff of trying to use the court proceedings to shore up its profit margins. Justice Ikia Sapoma insisted she was compelled to give the ruling given the urgency of the case. She, however, ruled that the balance of convenience was in the favor of the respondents, as they would stand to face the most hardships should the injunction be granted, thus the dismissal. Frema Ashka, manager for Kwabena Kwabena, could not hide her excitement at the ruling.
I was very confident that once we have credible law courts, we really had a good case, because we really don't have any issues with anybody. I don't think that you should let anybody intimidate you. You should let anybody frustrate you. If you do not understand anything, you don't lose anything by seeking clarification and also go to court and see what the law really says about such issues.
Your ladyship took the considered position that the application was brought in bad faith. She also went ahead to say that even if they won the case, they could be remedied by way of damages. She also considered the fact that the balance of convenience, because members of the general public had bought the tickets for the program already and that the program is scheduled for this evening. On those grounds, the ladyship dismissed the application.
Speaking off camera, lawyer for the plaintiff, Joseph Ashale, said although he accepts the ruling, he does not agree with it, since intellectual property rights and trade secret abuse cannot be compensated by cost. Gideon Oyeajo is the operations director of ABBA Investments.
We think if someone can take your concept and be able to go forward with it and get the general public to buy into it, and that becomes the balance of convenience that takes you away from the right, when it has to do with copyright, it has to do with concept, it has to do with investment. Yes, we disagree, but once there are serious issues of law to be tried, we look forward to the trial.